said that Lubor trained you to work iron, then that's what he'll expect you to use. But he would have known that it would either be too heavy or too brittle for a carving knife. Perhaps his Dalamil remark wasn't a riddle, but a hint.
If it's cheap metal you're using, then there's always limestone, I suppose.
Limestone and iron?
Folk first settled Dalamil to get at her mineral deposits. And if you know the trick, it can be melted down in the furnace to drive out impurities from low-quality iron.
Bloody hell! That must be it! I don't suppose you know the trick, do you?
It's hardly my speciality, but I've been around enough blacksmiths to know how it works.
Do you know my buddy Blackthorn?
Looks like I've got some learning to do. Clive, I hate to ask after all that you've done.
Just one more thing.
Fine. I can hardly abandon you now.
Do I not have any limestone on me?
I want to know if this is the answer to Lubor's little riddle.
I can't thank you enough, Clive. You'll have no trouble finding limestone over in the terraces. The place is bloody made of it.
Terraces.
I'll see you back at the forge.
Right you are. I'll see you shortly.
Well, it depends on how long it takes me to find the damn terraces. Gather limestone. Wait, is that what that white stone is over there? No, I can't be it. Oh, it's a completely separate little area. It's just fast travel to that, save from the run. There we go. Took a few moments. And, yeah, cut out half the distance need to go. So is this actually through the southern gate? Yeah.
Warm from the oven.
Well, since I'll be heading over there eventually in a moment, let's check out what's going on in the bathhouse. Might not require as much running around.
Are
you all right?
The baths are closed. Leave me be.
Perhaps you are just what I need. Might your services be for hire?
That depends on the job.
I'd have you save my business, the baths. The water's turned scalding hot and all the crystals in Dalamil wouldn't be enough to cool it.
I've no doubt that my woes stem from the water's source.
But I can't go and investigate for fear of my customers thinking I've abandoned the place.
If only we had Jill around. She could chill it down pretty damn fast.
Go to Dusnoff Terraces. Tell me what you find there.
I was just on my way there right now. Certainly.
Right. I'll go and take a look.
Wonderful. It's not far. Leave the market by the south gate. The smell of sulfur will guide you the rest of the way.
Yeah, out to get some sulfur.
Or all that keep me from an ignoble end in a debtor's prison. My livelihood, my very life, is at stake.
Not going to prioritize this one, because I'm going to go get the sulfur first, and then swap to this quest and cash them both in once I'm done. Oh, it actually is somewhat active then, hey? There's no other quest going on here, right? Yeah. This place is a little wild.
I'm not too late.
What is it, Lubor?
Question that I neglected to ask earlier. Where is it that you're bound?
To Drake's Fang. To finish Hugo Kuka.
Holy shit!
As I thought. Then allow me to share a secret. Drake's Fang is currently riddled with royalists.
I've killed a couple of them recently, so that's not a big deal.
As you've seen, their soldiers work hand in glove. But no nation has ever before allowed a foreign army to make a barracks of its holiest of holies.
Not by choice, at least.
And there's more. A man on the inside of the Fang has failed to report for several days. I fear there may be more trouble lying in wait for you on the road ahead.
Fantastic. I love trouble.
Isn't there always?
If you're determined to beard the lion's den, then promise me one thing. That you will enter via the mines, where the guard is lightest.
Sure? I'll try?
I've lost one Sid already.
Oh.
If I lose another, people will start to think me careless.
Now, for a second there, I thought you were warming up to me.
Not before Kupka does, anyway.
Well, so long as you have a plan.
Thanks, Lubal. Alright, so everything... Oh, everything's over this way.
Shall we press on?
Really? Just the limestone's right here? Oh, I think I see what the problem is with the springs.
One rock looks a lot like another. But hopefully this is what Seven needs.
I'll cash that out later. So how do I get... I need to take the whole way around. Okay. Hello, merchant.
Come on, girl. The gate's open now. We can press on. Don't tell me you put down roots.
Damn chocobos. You need some casual greens to get that chocobo moving. Very linear path here, actually. Traveling merchant.
Trader, are you? Seeking your fortune down in the golden sands of Dalamil? From mercantile stock myself, as it happens. You'd never guess. Well, I was born just down the road in Dravosht. And like my old ma and pa, I've been wandering the world hunting Gilbard's blessing ever since. Reckon I might have found it, too. You've heard about the famous healing waters they got round these parts, right?
Yeah.
I'm thinking, if I can find a little pool of my own, dress it up a bit, lay on drinks and fancies and whatnot, I'd have a license to mint gill. Soothing your aches and pains with a grape in your gob and a glass in your hand. There's nothing people wouldn't pay.
Nothing like a get-rich-quick scheme. I'm going to get rich from this one, and quick. Yeah?
What the hell are those things?
Those are bombs. So how far? As long as I take a right at the crossroads, then should be fine. Is there going to be any ambushes around here? There's no mention of this area being... Thought I saw something for a second there. Overrun by monsters and creatures and such. Hey, what you two up to?
Broken down, you say? From the weight of its load?
Aye. The guards are furious about it. You'd do well to steer clear.
Well, if it's blocking the road, it'd be a wasted journey anyway.
A wagon collapse with a shit ton of crystals? What we got going on over here? Oh!
Get that damned wagon fixed! Unless you'd rather our men in Dalamil starved!
The axle's gone, Captain. There's nothing I can do.
So a natural blockage for this path over here. Yeah, a nice little change of pace instead of having like a big old barricade and being like, oh, monsters that way. Be careful, sir.
Something awful's taken up residence in the springs. You'll turn back if you know what's good for you.
I don't, so I'm going to go out there and murder it all. But thank you for the warning. I appreciate it. Quite neighborly of you. Chest with some goodies, perhaps? Yes! Goblin coins, fangs, this and that. What? Okay. Get in there. Do some ass kicking. Some more desert roses. Getting a good number of those.
By the flames. Explains the heat.
Yeah, let's pop them right now. Ooh. Actually, I have enough of them in front of me. And they're fucking tough, too. Table flip. Wait. Get closer. Table flip. There. That took care of a decent number. Oh, you cheap shotting bastards. Get you with a little bit of a tornado. Leave you bumbling around in there for a moment. Wait, is that all of them? The bath bomb. That's cute. Oh shit, more of them, eh? Oh god, took that right to the fucking face. Oh, that hurt. Old Faithful. That's funny. Okay. Need to be a little bit more cautious of what I'm dealing with here. This son of a bitch is tough. Oh god, my spine! Little help with this son of a bitch! Trying to take down Old Faithful. I got him somewhat stunlocked. Oh, damn, I didn't want to table flip just him. Oh, he was the last one. Never mind. Okay, fine. Took a couple of pot shots in the back, but I'm fine with it.
Let's cool things down a bit.
Slay the bombs. Excellent. And as far as I can tell, it doesn't look like there's anything. Oh, nope. A little bit of loot over there. Want to grab that before I fast travel back. Oh, it's just 10 gil. Fantastic. Completely worthless. Alright. Travel back to Xavier. He'll be happy that we dealt with the bath bombs. That's funny. Reminds me of an image I saw online where it was a picture of a toaster. It was called a bath bomb.
I was hoping we'd be seeing you again. The baths grow more bearable by the moment. It won't be long now before we are back to business as usual.
I'm glad to hear it.
Now, tell me this. What did you find at the terraces? What threatened to make me a pauper?
Not what I expected, that's for certain.
Bunch of real pissed off angry fire monsters. Terrifying indeed!
You tell a fine story. That's not to say I don't believe you, though. Creatures made of flame, eh? That's something new to worry about.
Yeah, I would imagine.
I've burdened you with my worries enough already. Here, a small something by way of thanks.
No, it didn't say that there'd be a monetary reward.
I got back to work. With a little luck, the day might yet be salvaged.
Hot water. Yeah, I didn't get any money. I just got some renown. Ooh, Breath of the Inferno reduces ignition cooldown by 2.2 seconds. I don't think I use ignition either. Just getting all these really convenient or neat little baubles. Actually, what is the proper word that I'm looking for here? What the hell are these things? Yeah, badges. Different badges. And it's like, I don't use that ability. Don't use that ability. I love that table flip, though. God, it's so good. Hey, Sava. Got you your limestone.
You need, but I hope this is enough.
Or a spring lime? I thought it was limestone.
You are one of the good ones, you know that. You and that merchant boat, she's got quite a gift for teaching that one.
She's quite the looker as well, wasn't she?
Secret weapon we were hoping for.
Maybe I get to have the knife after? No, knife really wouldn't work for me. Oh boy, that's the best you could do, eh?
I'll do, I reckon.
Looks like shit,
the
but
knife forged from the very rocks of Dalamil. Her spirit, if you will.
It's a fine-looking blade.
No, it's not.
I only hope Master Lubor agrees.
Then again, he is just an apprentice.
And just as well. I was getting tired of waiting.
I'm sorry, Forgemaster Lubor.
Let's take a look then, shall we?
First
things first, Sava, do you think this is a carving knife worthy of the fine people of Dalamil?
I'd like to think so. But what do you think?
What do I think indeed? It's sharp.
Ish.
But won't last long with hard use. And it's heavy. Heavier than it should be. You might not think it just to hold it for a moment, but sell that to a cook and you'll never hear the end of it. It looks like someone paid a visit to the terraces. The limestone was a step in the right direction, granted, but one that still leaves you short of the mark.
And I was so certain I had it all worked out.
Need to practice on your metallurgy.
I can't teach you that little trick, but it certainly shows initiative.
Okay, so he didn't pass with flying colors, but...
How much do you think I would charge if I'd made this?
Well, if it took you even a fraction of the time it took me...
10 gil?
I would say you could demand a heavy purse.
For that heavy...
Who would be able to pay that?
Pretty... Well, not... well, not most durable.
The cooks over at the inn? Dalimil is home to humble traders, not wealthy lords and ladies. Rule number one in any business, Sava, know your customers.
Yes, Forge Master.
This is just about passable. But only just. I'd say you're worth keeping around a little longer.
I'd give it a D minus.
You'll have an anvil of your own.
I will. Thank you. I was wondering,
what now, boy?
You do if you were asked to forge a carving knife.
I'd do what I always do. Ask who it's for. If it was for the butcher, I'd make sure it holds an edge.
Oh, he tried to make something for everyone and made something that was for nobody.
And for the nobleman, I'd make it cost an absolute fortune.
Knowing your clientele, that is also very important.
There goes a master, all right.
It looks like congratulations are in order.
I couldn't have done it without you. So much for the Forge Master's riddle, though, eh? The spirit of Dalimil had nothing to do with limestone or anything much at all. Meaning... I had you run around for no good reason.
Go figure, huh?
That's your test. That's all that matters. You'll have a forge of your own in no time.
And when I do, I'll craft you the finest carving knife ever seen.
Not much of a use for a carving knife, but appreciate the sentiment. Carving out a niche. Cute. And 800 bucks for that. Nice. And some goblin coins. All right, not fucking around with little side quests here and there. Let's make a run for Drake's Fang, or fast travel back home and cash in some of this renown that I've been gathering up around here, and get whatever unlock that gives me as well. That's an idea. That's a plan. I like that plan. Might be something useful. Might be something where it's like, oh, this improves this ability that you just never use. Oh, and there's more on the hunting board, too. Hey.
Oh, I wasn't expecting you back so soon.
Oh, yeah. Oh, whoa, wait a second. What happened to the 305? Shit. It's because I flew past it too damn far? Alright, that wasn't what I was expecting. Ability, 800 ability points. Although I'm sitting on quite a wealth of ability points. Hey, Nectar. What you got in the hunt board here? You're going around killing creatures you haven't even looked up yet, Koopo. What the fuck? Okay. The Fast It. Tokalan. Yeah. Among Republican merchants, reports abound of caravans being crushed by a black boulder, a creature intermediate in nature, but quite decided in size, strength, and spite. He or she who took it upon themselves to seek out and slay this black mass would earn the eternal gratitude not only of the desert traders, but the curse breakers who risk their lives and limb with every trip through the Velcroy. Okay. She's just chatting about the same shite she always does. I wonder if any new weaponry has popped up. Weaponry or armor. Take a look at that first, and then head back and have maybe a little bit of a longer chat with the Lubel. Doesn't seem like you have anything new, do you, Blackthorn? Use the forge. Grindstone. Oh wait, no, that was one I looked at before. Was +5, +5, and it's like, yeah, I don't really care about the +5, +5. And Drinkslayer's bracelets, +3, +10. Oh, I got that from the gelatinous mass. Only when she saw the Drake no longer stirred and his eyes were gray with oblivion did she remove belt and bracelet, casting them into the worm's maw, where they might rest for an eternity. Legend of the Drake, translated by Moss the Chronicler. Sure, why not? That +10 defense could be pretty damn useful. How about you, Karen? You got anything interesting on hand? No, seems like you're running the same weak shit that I have, have already dealt with. Channeler's Whispers. The charge thing. 20,000, that is a little bit more. Ooh, earn money, 35%? Experience? Oh, shit! Increase ability points. Huh?
It better all be here.
Wait, what did that replace, though? What did that badge replace out of my gear? Well, it's not really a badge. It's an accessory, I suppose. Increases attack by 12, potions by that. It dropped that one I had for defense, I think it was. Pile drive, potions, aerial blast, ability points by 20%, so yeah, I think it increased defense by 30. 12 more damage, 30 more defense. I'd rather have the defense, because I can just always hit them with more spells. Just hit them harder. That's the beauty of that.
Guys, I figured out how we can beat them. We just have to hit them harder.
State of the realm, don't care. Reading table, check out later. That. Damn it, want to fast travel. So, back to Dilemma? Damn it, I forgot how to pronounce it already. And it brings me right into the middle of town. Fantastic. Just what I was hoping for. Hey, let's get some information out of you, you smug bastard. Ask about Luber.
You and I
have more in common than you might think. Not only are we both masters of the blade and devilishly handsome to boot, but we're both the second people to bear our respective names. You didn't think Ruzena Dalimil was my own invention, did you? It was the name of my master. I inherited it from her along with her title and her smithy. Ensuring that her name lived on was the least I could do after all she did for me. She plucked me from the streets and put my less than nimble fingers to work making blades instead of trouble. She was to leave my life as suddenly and unexpectedly as she had entered it. I swore to follow in her footsteps that I might change others' lives as she had mine. That is why I keep her forge alive. Why I play the desert hare, why I care for the orphans of Dalimil. Indeed, I had thought my obligations to Renz and Dikra to be my most pressing concern. That is until the infamous Cid made a surprise reappearance, rather muddied the waters. I suppose there's enough of me to go around, but do forgive me if the desert hare isn't always at your beck and call, won't you? Ask about the Dalimil Inn.
Ours is a blessed corner of the Velcroy.
Veritable oasis with clear running water and natural hot springs. I don't doubt that people have been gathering here since long before the founding of the Republic. Since it was founded, they've been gathering in even greater numbers to serve the needs of the miners who work Drake's Fang and the soldiers who guard it. And serve them they did, lining their coffers far from the prying eyes and grasping fingers of the Republican exes. Excisemen? Not that edicts from the Randelial carry much weight in these parts. Dalimil has long been something of a law unto itself. Here, those with the most money or the most friends make the rules.
At least they did.
Until Kupka built that castle of his at the heart of the Mother Crystal, Dalimil has been Titan's fiefdom since then. And while his men may be liberal with their coin, they are anything but in the exercising of their authority, which, as I am sure I don't need to tell you, is absolute. So. You see why those with the people's best interests at heart took it upon themselves to organize their own protection, my predecessor chief among them. Ask about the crystal trade.
How very fitting.
That the noble soldiers of Dalmechia and Walud, partners in arms on so many battlefields, should also become partners in crime. Still, the merchants of Dalimil will be relieved to see them brought to justice. Many have been driven almost to ruin of want of crystal. I'm sure they would all be rushing to thank you for the service you have done them, if, of course, they had any idea what you had done.
Of course.
As long as we remain reliant on the power of the crystals, we leave ourselves open to such exploitation. But people are such greedy, needy creatures.
There's simply no other way.
Clive, you must bring down each and every Mother Crystal and the twins, and put an end to the people's thoughtless dependence upon them. Do try not to disappoint me.
Alright, and here I was kind of worried that not having a supply of crystals from us destroying the Mother Crystals was causing harm and hardship to the people, but some people see it as too much of a crutch, and getting away from the reliance and dependence on them is an all-around benefit in the long run. In the short run, there's probably people that are cold and thirsty that wish that they had crystals at hand, but with the destruction of the Mother Crystals, that is no longer the case for a lot of them, which is a damn shame. The means justify the ends. You say that until you find people that are freezing because they don't have crystals to keep them warm, and people who are... Jesus, it's not starving. What is it when you don't have enough water? Thirsty. Just generally thirsty. Dehydrated. Severely dehydrated because of the lack of crystals to provide them delicious, necessary water. Fuck them. They're gonna die anyways. Make for Drake's Fang. Jaw obelisk activated. What a whole new environment to check out as well. Damn. This area just keeps spanning and spanning and spanning outwards.
Drake's Fang.
But it's inside the mountain. Can we actually see it? Not really.
Will be hiding inside.
Like the coward he is.
Along with goodness knows how many guards, all on highest alert, you'll need to keep your wits about you if you're to reach him. So be careful.
Wait, is this where we depart? Uncle. Or are you coming with me still?
Before you go, Clive, allow me to apologize.
Oh, we are going our separate ways, huh? Yeah, this was kind of on your way back home, eh?
What befell at Phoenix Gate and the crisis that followed in its wake, I fled. I retreated to my counting house and danced attendance upon the Viceroy in the hope it would bring me favor. I betrayed my nation to save my skin, like the coward I am.
Thank you.